Bye. 1922. This is 1933.
Let them get you or me. Everything's gonna be fine for the both of us. If not today, well then. Thus, that will come out tomorrow. Bet your bottom dollar that tomorrow there'll be sun. Just thinking about tomorrow clears away the cobwebs and the sorrow till there's none. When I'm stuck with the
thank you.
again, out in the freezing cold with just that new sweater. Thanks so much, officer.
All in the line of duty. Good afternoon.
Well, are you glad to be back, huh?
Yes, Miss Hannigan!
Liar! What's the one thing I always taught you? Never tell a lie! Good afternoon, Miss Hannigan.
Yes?
I am Grace Barrow, private secretary to Oliver Warbucks.
The Oliver Warbucks, the millionaire?
Mr. Warbucks has decided to invite an orphan to spend the Christmas holidays at his home.
What sort of orphan did he have in mind?
What about this child right here?
Annie? Oh, no, no. You don't want her.
Annie, would you like to spend the next 2 weeks at Mr. Warbucks' home?
I would love to.
If you get her coat, I'll take her along right now.
She don't have no coat.
Then I guess we'll have to buy her one. Come along, Annie. Merry Christmas.
On the way in.
She works for Oliver Warbucks.
The Oliver Warbucks? The millionaire?
Annie, one of the orphans, is gonna go live with him.
Crummy orphans!
Yeah, lived in the lap of luxury while the two Hankin kids get kicked off into skids.
It ain't fair how we spread out for $3 or $4 while she gets Warbucks, the little rat.
While we get peanuts, she's living fat.
Maybe she holds the key, that little lady,
to get more books
instead of less. Maybe we'll fix the game with something shady. Where does that put us? Give you one guess.
Sorry that I'm not a boy.
No, no, no. Well, Annie, we have to do something special.
especially your first night. Would you like to go to a movie?
Gee, Mr. Warbucks, I've never been to one.
Then we will go to the Roxy. Grace, you'll come too, of course. Drake, get our coats.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
have a man-to-man talk.
You're sending me back to the orphanage, right?
Of course not. Annie, I realize something. No matter how much money you've got, if you have nobody to share your life with, you might as well be broke. Here.
For me? What is it?
It's a silver locket, Annie. I noticed that old broken one you always wear. Annie, are you all right?
Well, this locket, my mother and father left it for me when they left me at the orphanage. And I know that I'm really lucky to be here with you this Christmas, Mr. Warbucks. But the one thing that I've always wanted is to finally find my parents again and be like other kids.
It'll be all right. I'll find them. I'll find them for you.
Thank you, Mr. Warbucks. Thank you.
we spoke to more than 1,000 people claiming to be your parents, but none of them knew about the locket.
It's okay. I guess a kid can get along without folks.
Grace, do you have those legal papers they gave you the other day?
Right here.
Annie, I want to adopt you.
Adopt me?
What do you think? Yes or no?
Well, if I can't have my real mother and father again, there's no one in the world that I'd rather have than a father than you, Mr. Warbucks.
Annie, this isn't just going to be an adoption. It's going to be a celebration. We'll have everyone from the orphanage here tomorrow for a big Christmas party.
I'm the luckiest kid in the world.
If you're the folks, surely look, there's Rainy.
Who are you?
Honey, we're your mom and dad.
Ralph's name, Ralph Mudge, and this is wife, Shirley.
And you're Annie Mudge.
Annie Mudge?
Here's our license and Annie's birth certificate.
Ralph, look! Annie's wearing the locket.
When we left Annie at the orphanage, we left half of us there with a locket and kept the other half. Yep, it fits perfectly. Yeah.
Mr. Mudge, what about the money?
Well, we ain't got much. We'd be glad to give you.
You haven't heard that I offered $50,000 to anyone who can prove they are Annie's parents?
No, sir. Anyway, we don't want no money.
On the other hand, Ralph, remember that pig farm out in New Jersey with $50,000? We can bring Annie up right.
Would you mind if Annie stayed here tomorrow morning? Then you can pick up Annie and the check.
Whatever you prefer.
Goodbye, Annie love.
Until tomorrow, honey, then you'd be spending the rest of your life with us. Pardon me, Blondie.
Merry Christmas!
Well, this is...
Mr. Warbuck, sir, I have the strangest feeling that I've seen that Mr. Mudge before, and that he's not who he says he is.
And I won't give up until we're certain.
But how?
I'll find a way. I'll go straight to the top.
Because I knew that they loved me, and they would have come back for me if they weren't Now who the heck are Ralph and Shirley Mudge?
Nobody knew about the Lockett except us.
And the FBI, of course.
And Miss Hannigan.
And Miss Hannigan.
Sir, Miss Hannigan, and the children from the orphanage?
Hi, kids! Sandy!
Annie! Hi, Annie!
Oh, Miss Hannigan, I'm delighted to meet you.
Same here, and I know you anywheres.
May I present you to the President of the United States?
Tell them how nice and good I always was to you.
Gee, I'm